Hello and welcome to another Surface Lab tutorial. My name is Julia and today I would like to show you some tips and tricks about the image program which you might not know yet. This video is inspired by frequently asked questions from our users. Let's start with the RGB overlay. Did you know when you open the context menu with the right mouse click, you can select Copy Overlay and paste it into your report? The software automatically adds the three color channels of the overlay. Let's go on with the ROI editor. You already know that you can use the threshold tool to select your region of interest. But did you know that you can limit the region where the threshold is applied as well? For this, create a rectangular region first, select it, and choose the threshold mode after that. On the worksheet, you can apply the 2D ROI to the image with the respective cell operation from the context menu. Let's focus on the line scan editor next. A line scan shows the intensity as function of the position across an image. Have you ever wondered what this colorful button down to the right is there for? It copies the line scan to the worksheet. Keep this button pressed, move the mouse to a cell on the worksheet, and release the button. But how to add more than one source image to the same line scan? Open the cell properties and select the entry Line Scan Sources in the property tree. Add more source images with drag and drop. The line scale will now show the plot for all added source images with the same definition of position. Mass interval subsets are a new feature in Surface Lab 7.1. You can use the subsets, for example, to group mass intervals which show a similar contrast in your image. Multi-select them in the image stockpile and drag them onto the New Subset tab. An image on the worksheet can be reduced in size by cropping. If a lateral shift correction was saved and is applied to your image, the autocrop function will cut off the negative overlap in the resulting image automatically. You want to make small changes to your 3D volume? It is not necessary to start the 3D rendering all over again. Just click on the Details button in the cell properties to resume your work. If you select Export Scan Resolved Image, you can export 3D data for each mass interval into an ASCII file containing the coordinates x, y, z and the intensity. The easiest way to bring images from the worksheet to your report is the print preview. You can select a certain range of the worksheet page to be shown in the printout. For this, the respective cell notation has to be used to define the start and the end of the shown range. I hope you have enjoyed this little video and have learned something new today. My name is Julia. Thank you for watching and goodbye.